I'm certain you've already written an initializer before. But did you know that initializers in Swift have some hidden features? Let me show you. Consider this initializer that creates a user and takes the user's name as its argument. Before we go ahead and create the user, we want to make sure that its name isn't empty. But what should we do in the case where the user's name is actually empty? A first solution is to make the initializer failable. You do it by adding a question mark just after the keyword init. And once the initializer has been made failable, it becomes possible to return nil inside its implementation. This will work perfectly, but there's a small drawback. The reason why the initializer failed will not be obvious at the call site. So if needed, we can improve on this by turning the failable initializer into a throwing initializer. Now our initializer has gained the ability to throw errors that will explain why the initializer failed. And if the caller is not interested in the details of the error, it can get back to the behavior of a failable initializer by using the keyword try question mark. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed learning about these advanced features of initializers. Thank you for watching and see you next time.